we are talking about the assumptions that we had in Bernoulli's theorem. So the first assumption is that it is inviscous fluid. Okay, there's a bigger equation that is called Navier-Stokes theorem. The outcome of that will be Bernoulli's theorem if you consider it to be inviscous and if you consider it to be laminar flow. Alright, and second assumption it is that it is incompressible. So if fluid, if it is compressible, the pressure force will do work in compressing the fluid also. Okay, that we have ignored. Alright, okay. Third assumption is what? A laminar, why are you forgetting that? It's a laminar flow. Laminar flow. Okay? And the fourth one, it is irrotational flow. The fluid should not rotate like that. Getting it? So these are the assumptions that we had when we were talking about the Bernoulli's theorem in fluid dynamics. Clear? Okay. So we are going to discuss few properties that do not have these assumptions. For example, the most important property of the fluid which differentiates between between honey and oil is what? Viscosity. Right? Honey is not able to flow as freely as the oil is flowing or water is flowing. Okay? But that kind of differentiation, these equations do not take care of it. Because they will assume that if pressure difference is something, the rate of flow will be same whether it is honey or whether it is oil. Volume flow rate I am talking about. Okay? So now we are going to talk about one of the most important property of fluid, which is viscosity. Please write down viscosity. So whenever we encounter this term viscosity, immediately the flow of the honey will come in our mind. That usually is the case. Okay, so you will see that, you know that the thicker fluid, for example honey, doesn't flow very easily. So suppose you have little bit of honey on this plane, on that plane you have little bit of water. If you incline it like that, due to their own weight, water will flow suddenly and honey will take time to flow. Are you getting it? Alright, now tell me one thing, that the amount of deformation, let's talk about this. Flow is what? Shear deformation. How much the upper layer is moving relative to the lower layer, that is what is flow, that we have discussed. Okay, for example, if let us say this is a fluid body, let's say this is honey itself. Okay, now if the upper surface is moving relative to the lower surfaces, the situation will be something like this. The upper surface moves forward, the lower surface remains here and lower than that further, like this, right? So there is a displacement of the upper surface compared to the lower one, like that. Okay, now tell me one thing, this movement of the upper surface, if you apply a small amount of force, will be more wear in case of honey or in case of oil if I leave it for large amount of time, sufficient amount of time? Will honey stop flowing after some time if you keep on applying force? It will not stop, it will move, but it is moving slowly. Are you getting it? The amount of deformation will be similar whether it is oil or whether it is honey, but it is the rate at which it is getting deformed will be different. That differentiate a more viscous fluid from a less viscous fluid. Whereas in case of solid, the solid get deformed little bit and it stops because the resistance force is equal to what force you are applying, so it will stop there.
But fluid offers almost zero resistance against the flow. So if you apply a small amount of force also, it will slowly and slowly get displaced. Alright? So if I have to quantify viscosity, now we have discussed the viscosity in terms of words only, that there should be something like viscosity which takes care of the fact that some fluid is moving slowly, as in flowing slowly, and some fluid is flowing faster. Okay? So there we need to quantify the viscosity. Right now we have just discussed the concept of viscosity. Alright? So we are going to take the concept from the solids chapter and try to define the coefficient of viscosity. Ultimately it is a shear deformation only, right? And you remember in case of solid, we have defined the shear modulus or the modulus of rigidity. What was that? You remember? G was equal to force divided by area of cross section divided by delta. It is theta only, which is, if you consider a solid getting deformed, then theta is roughly equal to x by L. Yes or no? So this is x by L. This was the modulus of rigidity. If G is more, what does it signify? If G is more, you can see that F by A is equal to G times x by L. So F is equal to Gx by L into A. So if G is more, for the same amount of displacement of the upper surface x, I need to apply more amount of force. Yes or no? And this is the force of resistance also. Fine. So in a way, G, the constant G, signifies how strong the material is. Yes or no? Alright. Similarly, similar kind of parameter I am going to define for the viscosity also. Okay, but with viscosity, x is infinite. X will never stop deforming. But the velocity of deformation will be different. So I will define, just like G is defined, I will define a constant for viscosity, which is called coefficient of viscosity, denoted by eta. Okay, this eta is equal to force divided by the area of the upper surface, force of resistance between the two layers divided by the area of cross section, divided by what? Velocity of the upper surface divided by length. Are you getting it? Rather than writing x by L would have been what? Strain. Okay, and V by L is what? Derivative of this, dx by dt divided by L, which is strain rate. Rate of deformation is strain rate, which will be different among the fluid. Alright, a more viscous fluid have lesser strain rate than a less viscous fluid. Okay, so I am not using x by L because we cannot quantify x by L in case of liquids. So we are using strain rate. Please write down. Strain rate is V by L, and this is coefficient of viscosity. Fine. Okay. Now if coefficient of viscosity is more, it automatically indicates that the force of resistance between the two layers is more. Okay. Viscous force is like a frictional force between the two layers. Alright? And this V is what? V is a relative velocity between the two layers. Are you getting it? V is a relative velocity. Both the layers are moving the same velocity, then V is zero. Okay? So both the layers should be moving with different velocity. So V is a relative velocity. Now we will consider cases. Most of the time we'll be considering cases in which the bottommost layer is at rest. Okay, it is a scenario like this. The fluid is kept on the surface. The example of honey that we have taken, in which honey is kept on a plane and we are inclining the plane like that. The lowermost layer of the honey is in contact with the ground. It will move with the ground. So if ground is stationary, the lowermost layer is stationary. Okay, but the uppermost layer will have some velocity. Let's say V is the velocity. Okay, so if you consider relative velocity between the lowermost layer and the uppermost layer, then you can consider this as thickness. Okay, but this layer has some velocity. If you consider relative velocity between this layer and that layer, then you have to consider this as the thickness, L. Fine. So just to make it simpler, we are considering the lowermost layer and the uppermost layer. So the actual velocity becomes a relative velocity if the lowermost layer is attached to the fixed ground. Alright, any doubt? Now tell me the unit of viscosity, quick. What should be the units of viscosity? It cannot be zero. The thing is that if you are applying force, if you apply force, then also relative velocity is not zero. It is like solid. Are you getting it? So you, the numerator is also zero. Tell me, what is the unit?
Newton seconds per meter square.
Newton. See, don't tell me unit Newton. Tell me in term. Tell me the dimension in mass, length, and time.
Sir,
m.
M minus one. L p minus one.
M l minus one. P minus one. Kg per meter per second. Isn't it simple? Why are you struggling with this? Coefficient of viscosity is F by A, V by L. F is kg meter per second square divided by area, which is meter square, divided by meter per second divided by meter. So meter gone. And it will become second one. So this will be kg per meter per second. This the unit of coefficient of viscosity. Okay. What is F here? F is what? The force of resistance. Okay. It is the force of resistance. It is like friction. Okay? Fine? Right? Let us do a numerical on what we have done just now. We have quantified a very important property of fluid, viscosity. First, we have observed that, you know, there is a property of fluid that makes one fluid flow easier than the other fluid. Okay? And then we named that property as viscosity, and then we have quantified that. We have assigned a number to that. Alright? Let's take a numerical. Please draw this figure. Okay, here is a question. A metal block is there. This is a metal block, alright, which has cross section area 0.1 meter square. It is connected to 0.01 kg mass like this. The thickness of the fluid film is 0.3 mm. The object is moving with a velocity of 0.085 meter per second. 085. This object is moving with constant velocity of 0.085 meter per second. You need to find the coefficient of viscosity. This chapter is done in the school, right?
Yeah.
No. Minus? I think it is a direct formula of substitution. -3 Okay? Any doubt? Clear, right?